Service has confirmed that about 7 tornadoes actually touched down in St. John, in primarily La Place. We do have emergency personnel out and about. They're working with our sheriff's office, our fire department. We actually have volunteers from our neighboring parishes that have helped to clear debris from the roadways. We have participation from GOSEP, and of course, our parish workers are out and about in the damaged areas. We are asking our residents to proceed with caution. There are signal lights that are still out because there's approximately 9,200 residents without power, so our signals are not working, and it's not safe for them to be on the major roadways. We're also asking them to proceed with caution as they try to remove the trees and tree limbs and the damage from their homes. But should there be an injury, our emergency rooms are open, and they can contact us here at 911 or 985-652-2222 for assistance so we can get someone out as soon as possible. The major damage that's being seen throughout the parish is roof and home damage, and it is significant. We have approximately 200 structures that are damaged. Many of them are unlivable. Many vehicles have been damaged as well. Fence damage, roof damage, and debris that has flown throughout the parish into other neighborhoods. And again, we do have crews out. They worked until about 11:30 last night, clearing the roadways of the debris and trees. However, early this morning, they were back at the same task. We are in touch with the Weather Service. The worst is past us, but it's a little bit cooler. We're expecting a little more rain, but nothing like we experienced yesterday. All of our public private schools are closed. The Technical College is closed, and that's located in Reserve, and we'll keep you posted. Because of the power outages and the roadway closures, we're not going to recommend opening schools at this time. We do have a representative from the school system who is in our EOC with us, and so we'll make those decisions jointly. As I said, there are approximately 9,200 outages. Entergy has crews staged in St. John the Baptist Parish. They are having to replace poles and transformers, so that's a huge issue. We're asking residents to proceed with caution when connecting generators. Do that safely, and we'll keep you alerted as to when power is being restored. The major outages that are affecting Airline Highway from La Place Park to Belterre Boulevard, Sugar Ridge Subdivision, and New Era, that's why the roads closed on Airline Highway. There are significant power line damage and some debris across Airline Highway. As soon as that's cleared, then we'll be able to open that area. Other areas significantly hit are our Carrollwood Subdivision, Foxwood Subdivision, Belterre, Riverlands, Cambridge. All these are power outages. Cambridge Subdivision, and again, that's 9,200. When we talk about the areas that are damaged, again, some of the same areas that were impacted by Hurricane Isaac, which is devastating to some of our residents, but these are the areas: Spring Meadows and the Meadows Subdivision, Indigo Parkway, Palmetto Drive, Sawgrass, Cambridge, Yorktown, south of St. Andrews, north of Fairway, the Riverland Subdivision, West Frisco, East Frisco, Evergreen, Bell Alliance, Kenilworth, Greenwood, Maidwood, Ridgeville, part of the Belterre areas, and again, Carrollwood. These are areas that we're asking, if you do not live in those areas, and if you're not working in those areas, that you stay away from them, because we have homeowners that are trying to restore their property. There's debris in the roadways that could damage your vehicle and cause other problems. Additionally, because of the debris that's staged on the sides of the roads, there's not a lot of space for sightseers. So again, these are the areas that are damaged, and we're asking residents who do not belong in those areas to stay away, and if possible, stay in their homes. We did have a curfew last night from 10 to 6. We want to thank our sheriff, who is here, and I'm sure he'll speak in a minute. That worked very well. Few problems, so that curfew has been lifted. Major closure, the ramp at exit 206 into La Place is closed. It is closed because of the problems we're having on Airline Highway. So we're directing all the truck traffic to remain on the interstate and go to the Gramercy exit if possible. Right now, for our residents that are primarily using River Road, the traffic is very heavy. The arteries are having difficulty accessing River Road. So again, for our truck traffic and business traffic, we're asking that you not come down Airline Highway, but stay on the interstate and use the Gramercy exit if you need to come back. For our residents, keep in mind from Belterre to New Era, Tiffany is closed, and we're not sure when that will be open. So plan for detours in that area. Woodland Drive from Indigo Parkway to Highway 51 is also closed, and that's related to power line damage. Again, use caution, especially in the areas where there is damage, and we're just going to ask if you find things that we have not acknowledged where there are trees in the roadways, please call 911 or emergency operations office so we can make sure to barricade or send someone out to deal with that. We know power outages are inconvenient for many of you, but they're devastating to us as a government. It impacts our ability to provide basic services, so our utilities crews are out trying to use generators where possible, mobile generators to deal with our sewer system and lift stations. So at this time, we're going to ask our residents to conserve water while we work toward getting our power outages restored. There are in excess of 144 lift stations throughout the parish. Many of them, the larger ones, are in the damaged areas. So again, we're going to ask that they conserve water because that will obviously go into the sewer system. Activities such as washing clothes, running the dishwashers, and unnecessary types of activities, we're asking that you discontinue. A shelter has been set up temporarily. It's located at Emily C. Watkins Elementary School, which is located at 938 Highway 628 or River Road in La Place, and it is open for residents who sustained substantial damage to their homes. Red Cross has provided some basic supplies there, but we're asking if you go into the shelter to please bring toiletries and home care items. There are food items that are being prepared, and we're actually awaiting Red Cross to go out into the damaged areas to provide snacks, water, and some meals to those individuals who may not be able to make those preparations or maybe attempting to work on their homes. We've started to get donations and offers for volunteers around the country, as was done during Hurricane Isaac. We are coordinating that in our office. Days of Hope, who was here during Hurricane Isaac, will be sending about 150 to 200 volunteers here to help residents remove debris from their homes, remove tree limbs and branches. So we're asking, if you're in need of assistance, please call 911 or 985-652-2222. We have not received an abundance of calls from our residents, but based on the damage that we've seen, there's clearly a great need. We are working on providing disaster food stamps. That has been approved at the state level. We're in the process of determining a location and staffing levels to be able to distribute those, so we'll provide more information as it becomes available. Again, we're going to be working with Celebration Church, who is going to be working with us to coordinate our volunteers. As more information comes regarding what's available to our residents, we'll be putting that out. We do encourage them to listen to, obviously, WWL if there is no power, to make sure that they're on our parish website, which we'll be putting out updates regularly. And I want to thank all of your stations because you've been releasing the information that we've been providing to you. That is a source of information for our residents, and we'll continue to do that. Pets. We also are taking in pets at the shelter, as we've done in the past. If you have damage to your homes and you want to go to a shelter, feel free to bring your pets. We have animal control on site and a plan in place to deal with those pets. You can call the animal shelter phone number at 985-651-7387 if there's a concern about your pet, or if you want to leave your home and need information about how to take your pet with you. Again, we're encouraging our residents to monitor the news stations. You guys have done a great job. This was devastating to our community once more. Again, one tornado is bad enough, and to have seven in one very small location has set us back, but we're working very hard, as you can see. We have a group of people behind me that have been here all day, many all night, and we are here for the residents, and we're going to get through this as we've done before. I'm going to let our sheriff speak for a minute, and then we'll have our, is our council chairman here? And then we'll open it up for questions. Sheriff Drake.
Good morning. First of all, I'd like to thank the parish and all of the people you see behind me. It was a complete team effort in the worst chaotic set of circumstances that took place yesterday. Everybody did their job. Everybody responded best as we could possibly have responded. I'm very proud of how everything went yesterday. Unfortunately, we learned through prior experience, and here we are again today. Secondly, I want to thank all of the brother law enforcement agencies that have called and offered manpower and resources. Sheriff New Norman, Chief Harrison, NOPD, and I know they got their plates full, but they're still calling to offer aid and assistance and manpower. The Louisiana Sheriff's Association, all of the agencies that have been calling. We have not taken them up on those offers just yet, but as recovery efforts take place, my manpower may experience fatigue, so I may take them up on those offers of manpower at some point. It's ironic, yesterday when the tornado struck, I was actually sending a team to St. James Parish to aid and assist them with their efforts, and I spoke directly on the phone with Sheriff Willie Martin at the height of his crisis, and wouldn't you know, I had to call my people back because of our tornadoes that struck our community. So this is day two, and this is what I would like to say to the citizens. We've been riding the streets this morning. We're looking at them in their eyes. They are resilient residents. They are cleaning up their homes. They are taking care of their property. Thank God nobody died. I'm very thankful and prayful that, I don't know how it happened, but God is definitely in control. But when we rolled this morning, if you look into these residents' eyes, they will rebuild, they will be here, and we welcome anyone who's coming here for the right intentions. Now, for those who are coming here for the wrong intentions, that's where law enforcement, that's where my job comes into place. We will be out here. Very, very strong presence, marked, unmarked units. We're going to be out here for the duration until we see that everything is safe and secure. For those that will come out here and try to steal or loot, listen, hopefully you hear this broadcast. It may not be the sheriff's office you have to fear. The residents will protect themselves. They will protect their property. It may turn out that you may be the one that needs 911 services. So I'm just putting that out there. If you come out here to St. John Parish for the wrong reasons, you may have more problems than Sheriff Mike Tregg or St. John Sheriff's Office. They are prepared. They've been here before. And I'm just putting that out there. They will protect themselves. Now, please, residents, citizens, if you call, if you see something that's not normal, if somebody's out here that's not supposed to be, call 911 and let us do our job. That's what I'm asking for, safety and security, and let the people who have suffered through this tornadic event, let them get on and rebuild their lives, and let St. John Parish rebuild and regroup like we've done in the past. We've been here before, we're here again. It's not how many times you get knocked down, it's how many times you get up. And I think that we are ready to get up and get on our feet. As you can see, there's a lot of activity in the parish. The parish president has spoken to everyone about traffic concerns. We're going to be here for the duration. If you need us, call 911. And we'll take questions after the next speaker. Thank you.
Oh, I'm looking for, and I'll share with you, information regarding our long-term recovery group and a contact. You know, whenever things like this happen a first time, there are social and emotional needs that occur in families and children. When it's recurring, we anticipate that that's going to be even greater. We do have Pastor August with our long-term recovery group, who is also a representative of our faith-based organizations. They are establishing a process and a phone number. Do you have that?
504.
I'll let you share that. What we're asking is that you give, call this number, and if there's assistance needed with regard to that, we will provide it through our long-term recovery group. But we need you to reach out to us and let us know that that is a concern for you. If there are other needs, we definitely want you to call our 911 center and our emergency operations office so that we can be prepared. But know this, we are working hard every day. Everyone up here is committed to helping our residents and our parish get back to normal. Every resource that's available, we're going after, and those that we may be denied initially, we're going to keep pushing. There are some things underway now. We know this community is strong and resilient, but at this time, we need help. We are a very small community. We've been through a lot, and we're going to ask for and push for everything we deserve to make sure that our residents can get back into their homes, remain safe, and get back on their feet. So I'm going to ask Pastor August to provide the information about the services he's offering through our long-term recovery group, and then we'll go back to questions.
Thank you, President Rowbottom. Pastor Checkers Williams of Celebration Church and myself are working along with the parish to assist with volunteer assistance to the residents and anyone who may suffer any traumatic injury or mental, emotional disturbance from this occasion. You can call us at 504-458-2564. Or you can call through the parish, and they'll direct your information to us, and we'll be there to assist you. Again, this is the second time in less than 4 years, so for many people, it's a rewind. And we just pray that they're able to handle the challenges that come. Thank you.
Okay, any questions?
You mentioned Hurricane Isaac and how this situation is kind of similar in terms of rebuilding and getting back into people. How does this compare, the devastation of these tornadoes? How do they compare to Hurricane
Isaac? In riding through the neighborhoods, it's almost worse, because you're looking at individuals that have no home to go to. When we had some of the water damage, you know, you could still get back into your home. Some of them had different levels of water in their homes. But what we're looking at is just total devastation to some of the homes and the neighbors and the number. And unfortunately, it's some of the same residents that were impacted by Hurricane Isaac. And as you know, some of those individuals were impacted by Hurricane Katrina. So for some people, this may be a third event, which is why we are definitely setting up a number for calls to deal with those types of concerns. But at this point, some of the areas, the damage is significantly worse than Hurricane Isaac.
Is there an estimation of how many households or businesses
have been impacted? We actually have a number of businesses. The households, we would say it's in excess of 200. With regard to the businesses, there are a number of businesses that are impacted. We're working on Walmart right now, providing energy to Walmart. It is closed. Many of the businesses along Airline Highway from Carrollwood or Hemlock going eastward on Airline are open. They have power. Of course, our businesses in Reserve and along the river are set. But the businesses that are located along Beltair Marché, that plaza was, I guess, damaged by tornado, as well as their power outages. Beltair Plaza, which is next to Walmart, all of those businesses, which is PJ's and All Star and Wonder Cuts and French Riviera, all of those sustained significant damage to their buildings. That's primarily right across from our center. But many of the commercial structures are being assessed. We do have our economic development director that is reaching out to the business owners to see what damage they have and what services we can provide. That is Ms. Tori Buckles. So if there are businesses that we may not have reached, we're asking that you call us so we can make sure that we're aware of what's happening with you and put you in touch with the resources to get you back open as soon as possible.
You said there were no deaths unfortunately, but were there any injuries significant enough?
There were very minor injuries. Again, as the sheriff said, you know, God is in control. For the amount of damage, some of the homes, some of what we've seen out there in the communities, the fact that there were minor injuries is amazing. Now, we did have our fire department out. We rescued individuals who were trapped in their homes. We had vehicular accidents or incidents where they were turned over and they had to rescue people out of their vehicles. And the fact that very few had major injuries or any injuries is absolutely amazing. And that is something that we are grateful for. We pray for our neighbors in St. James Parish and any of the other areas that were hit as well. But if we have a saving grace, is that there were very few of any injuries. We are dealing with individuals who may be on medication, maybe elderly, so we're trying to deal with those situations. They're not directly related to the tornadoes, but as a result of not having power and not having access, we are monitoring what they're doing. We do have a physician in our EOC who helps us triage and make referrals. We have Acadian Ambulance. The emergency room is open. And, of course, we also had EMT from St. Charles Parish who was assisting us. Our neighbors are wonderful. We had President Yenny and his staff from Jefferson Parish. St. Charles Parish is providing equipment. Obviously, we know that St. James would provide if they could. As the sheriff said, we were sending firefighters to St. James. That is what we do in this area. When we saw our neighbors were in need, we were there to help, and we know that we're going to get help from our neighbors as well.
Back to work.
Any other questions? Last question I have.
Do you have an estimated time frame for
It's estimated by tomorrow at 5, and that's an estimate. Obviously, there are some areas that have not been touched, depending on the weather. If it's raining, that interferes with their ability to complete their assessment. It is gradual. Unbelievably, some of the areas that were hardest hit has power, which is absolutely unbelievable to me. There are structures with only a slab, and there's power to that area. So we're going to continue to have the Entergy representative working with us. The major push is our commercial corridor right now, but there are crews coming in from other places, and the anticipation is to get back up by tomorrow afternoon.
In St. James Parish, I know that there were a few people reported missing. Is that the case at all here?
No, that is not.
Any other questions?